Meow, 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 meow. This is the Freedom Fiends. Trigger warning. Triggering you with the most delicious diet of worms the central scrutinizers will allow. We tip every sacred cow, kill every Buddha on the road to rattle the infantilized masses into existential crisis. Can you feel it, Jim? Can you feel it?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's good to be with you, Jim. I heard you survived post-pope-pocalypse. I was outside of Philadelphia and the whole East Coast region when the Pope came to visit. But you made it out okay. Did you have to go through any of those outside TSA checkpoints? Maybe the CIA did get him. Or the TSA. I heard they found some salt water on Mars. It's possible that the aliens in Alpha Centauri heard the fiends broadcasting and came on down to pick up our friend Jim. Hopefully he returns unprobed. I also heard that the Pirate Bay founder is free after 3 years. Big celebration for that. And that people decided they can control computers with their brains. There's new implants that they're using to control computers. They were doing a cool little test, just controlling the cursor on a screen. It's a very simple elementary operation of controlling their computers with their thoughts, but this could expand to other realms. There are like 3D printed arms that people can print in their homes now with circuitry included. Cost only about $3,000.
Fiend phone.
Jim, do the aliens just drop you off?
I'm back. Yeah, I think it was a near miss drone strike took out my internet connectivity. Yeah. They missed, but the EMP pulse disrupted my system for a moment. So.
Well, welcome back to Guantanamo Gay. So, yeah, I was just talking. I wanted to hear about your adventures through the Pope-pocalypse. Pope-pocalypse, the one where... Did you have to go through any of those TSA checkpoints? I saw the TSA,
I stayed clear
outside.
Of the whole thing. I don't go near those things, you know, but
I didn't want to have fun?
Sure, I wanted to have fun, but my idea of going into the largest urban security zone that the country's ever seen is not really what I was looking for.
Were the police wearing riot gear and stuff?
Well, they had the National Guard out wearing like full camouflage with orange safety vests on top of that. So
I saw that. That's so bizarre looking. Why would they do that, I wonder? I mean, it's not camo.
They want to let you know that they're there blending in, right?
Like they're there in charge. It's like a it's authoritarian gear, but it's like layered on authoritarian gear, and it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, it's conflicting wardrobe missions there, but which you know the whole thing was just from what I understanding like just something to avoid. In fact, all the businesses are all complaining. They compared it to a hurricane where everybody stayed home. And Steven Starr, you know, the big restaurateur, he compared it to the hurricane in the Philly Inquirer. And he said, you know, the city completely overreacted. And what should have been a fun time with families ended up being like this military lockdown. So, you know, what are you going to do?
Family. Nah, I don't know. It sounds like it was pretty horrible. I don't know. Did anyone even get to see? Did he walk through the streets, or was he in one of those Pope mobiles?
He had a Pope mobile, my friend Richard, he got to see him. And from what I understand, the people that had fun in the city were the bikers, the people that had bicycles, because they closed off all the streets. I mean, literally, like including the Schuylkill Expressway, the Ben Franklin Bridge. They shut off the highways.
Major highways.
Yeah, they shut off all and cleared all the streets. They cleared and blockaded streets like a mile away from where the Pope was going just so they could, I don't know, have more fun locking stuff down. They towed all the cars away, but you could ride your bikes freely, you know, without cars. And so people were kind of enjoying that aspect.
Is it too, like, conspiratorial of me to be like, hey, this is, like, practice for what they really want to do? Like, you know, the people in charge want exercise, locking things down. Like, I imagined Philly this way when I used to live there. Like, hey, this city wouldn't be too hard to just block off the major streets, the arteries to the city, and keep everyone inside if they wanted to, right?
Well, I'm sure, you know, it was an exercise, you know, and they called it the National Guard. Somebody said it was called Operation Iron Response, in case the Pope visit goes wrong. Like, you know, I guess I don't know what goes wrong means, but, you know, I guess I can sort of understand the need for concern. I mean, over in, you know, the tragedy over in Mecca with people getting stampeded and with their religious fervor. You know,
yeah, I heard about that. Is that how people were dying in that? The visit to Hajj, was people stampeded over each other? They were
in such
a rush to get to the Holy Land. What, were they late? I mean, why were they stampeding on each other?
I think it's just a concert? Like too many people in too small of a space, and they have to do it during a certain period, and it just ended up being a fatal disaster for, I heard it was like 4,000 people. Like, it was an awful tragedy. So,
wow, that is sad.
You know, so I can sort of give, you know, them a little bit of a leeway and say, hey, you know, they probably want to take some precautions, but they just went completely overboard and took and like literally blocking off streets that were nowhere near where the Pope was going for no apparent reason.
No one in the streets. I mean, like no one was packing the streets to go see the Pope and try and touch his holiness. Was he throwing out money or anything? Was he throwing holy water at anyone?
The official report said 800,000 people, but then some some crowd security expert analyzed the photos and said, it looks like about 142,000, which is still a lot of people. But there's really no need to lock down the city for something like that. It's just, it's a lot of people. And it should have been disrupting that area, but there's no need to. I mean, they literally shut down the Schuylkill Expressway, like leaving the city at nighttime, like when everything's closed up, the Pope's asleep, and they've still got blocked highways for some reason.
That's weird.
Yeah.
I wonder what that's about. I mean, like, I'm thinking there's got to be some ulterior motive here. Like, that is an exercise in the government's ability to respond to disaster or cause one. I don't know.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe
well, what's the difference? Right. It's the same response either way. Yeah. Like, if there is a disaster, their response will be to make it worse. And if there's no disaster, they can certainly manufacture one.
Although I heard that Mayor Nutter, the mayor of Philadelphia, which is his real name, was on. He was on a high horse, I guess, as the expression goes, about deriding the media for making too much hype of the whole thing.
Oh, right.
He even,
well, yeah, he blamed the media. He said, you guys, he actually said, you scared the S out of people in his press conference.
I'm sure they had never heard that word before. It's so weird, like the control over media. I would think that it would be gone by now. Like, it's been, 40 years since the naughty words list came out. It's like, doesn't culture get a little more accepting over time? Like, why are we still censoring this stuff?
Well, you know, like, I mean, I would say it now. I really don't think the FCC would get on me, but I bet Michael Dean would if I said that word.
Yeah, no,
so
I know.
So as a courtesy, I'm not going to say that.
I know why we censor ourselves. I'm just saying, like, culturally, generally, like, why is it still an issue? Is the FCC does come after people over this?
I don't know.
They shut down stations?
I think it's probably just more to do with just common decency and courtesy. You know, and people want to have a nice listening experience. Yeah, he doesn't care about that. He wanted to seem edgy. I'm the edgy, cool mayor that can say, you know, curse words in my press conference and everybody thinks it's cool. But
isn't he the one who locks down the city? I mean, it's not the media.
Of course.
Yeah, so he's like
just trying to pass the buck
here
on somebody. Right. Because when you have like the head of the city industries going, what the heck was going on here? This is a disaster. You brought a hurricane into us. You've cost us countless, I don't know, millions, tens of millions of dollars in lost revenue for businesses.
Lost revenue? I would think the businesses would do well. Wasn't the city packed?
No.
I mean,
no.
Despite the
restaurant, nobody wanted to go to restaurants. Nobody wanted to stay in the city because everybody was warned to stay away. So,
So the
restaurants were all empty.
Bizarre. Yeah, it's like, I can't imagine Philly like a ghost town like that. It sounds really scary, like ominous. I mean, were you walking through the streets or anything, or did you lock in?
No, I just
like the government
I stayed.
Told you to?
I just stayed clear. I had other things to do anyway, but I had friends that were there, and I saw a lot of the pictures, and there was about, looked like about 10,000 porta-johns, like, lining every street, like, every
single
street.
Did the Pope use any?
I'm assuming he used every one, right?
The blessed porta-john.
How about that Pope? Congressman, Bob Brady, who stole his drinking glass? I thought that
was hilarious. His holiness. Is that what he's called? His holiness?
His excellency or his popalness? I don't know what they call him.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, he stole the glass, and then what was he? He was feeding the drinking water to his children in hopes that there was some backwash in there that would
Some
give
holy
them extra
spittle
powers.
Would might transmit some magical powers.
Yeah. They'll start to levitate things and
But, you know, it's funny because the rational people were quick to point out, be like, hey, you know what? He was really crazy to do that because that water doesn't get magical powers until the Pope does the blessing. And he didn't do the blessing, so it's not magical. Anybody knows that. Like, oh.
Oh, man. Well, he'll get it next time. I heard the same congressperson, whatever he is, stole a glass from Obama in the past too. So he's got, like, this is his shtick now. Ooh. This is his thing. He's always stealing glasses of water and trying to drink from other people's
maybe
glasses.
You know what, maybe he's like secretly collecting DNA samples and he's gonna like create some kind of weird clone army.
I could see a cross between the Pope and Obama. That could be fun.
The ultimate merger of church and state. Obama.
Worms.
You and the hamster in your brain are listening to Freedom Fiends with Michael Dean and his weird friends.
Are you sick of peaceful people being locked away for victimless crimes? Instead of trying to get out of jury duty, consider taking it so you can do the right thing. A single juror with a conscience can send someone home to their family instead of to a jail cell. If there's no victim, how can there be a crime? And if the judge or prosecutor are keeping you in the dark, what are they trying to hide? You can vote your conscience instead of being a pawn of the state. For more information, Google jury nullification or check out the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Freedom without the fish burps.
Fish burps?
Without the
what are fish,
fish
burps?
Oh, it's what,
are,
you get
what is
you
that?
Those, if you take those vitamin E supplements, the
oh, yeah,
lower
true.
Grade ones,
ew,
they come with fish burps.
That's so gross. Yeah.
Yeah.
No,
so,
I don't want that.
Freedom Fiends doesn't have that.
Thank goodness.
Yeah.
Hey, I was wondering, what was your kids' reaction to Pope-pocalypse? Did they have any thoughts on what was going on?
Well,
did they want to go out and play, meet the Pope?
I think Dorothy was annoyed because they actually closed her school. They closed her school.
What?
Yeah, just because.
Why would they do that?
Just because, you know.
Did they think a lot of kids would want to attend? Like, hey, you know, these parents are going to want to take off from work and go see the. His Pope-ness.
No, it's a Quaker school. They don't really have many, you know, I don't think there's a whole lot of Catholics go there. It's mostly Jewish folks and secular people. But it was just, I think basically they figured there'd be no way to get to the school just through the mayhem. Center City. It's not even in Center City, but they just figured the whole region is just going to be breaking down. Civilization will be collapsing. We better just call off school for the day.
It's amazing to me. Like, part of me thinks that this is a distraction, like an intentional designed distraction. Like, the media was all about it. It was like an orchestrated event, like from top down or something. Like, all right, here's the thing everyone's going to be focusing on. This is the big story. We're not going to talk about how all the economies around the world and the countries. Central banks are running out of money, and they can't raise any interest rates, and they can't pay their loans. We're not going to talk about any of that. We're going to talk about this guy in white who's wearing a silly hat, and he blesses things and drinks out of water. We're going to talk about him for a while, like the whole week. It's going to be the number one news story.
And the stuff that he talked about, it didn't seem like it had anything to do with like Jesus. It was all about like his socialist agenda. So
yeah, yeah, that was pretty strange. It's
kind of weird to see how the left is treating him, right? Like the left, like is normally is like, oh, those Catholics, they're anti-abortion, anti-divorce, you know, anti-gay marriage, normally the church seems to be associated with the right wing. Okay, so all those people that used to criticize the Pope and the Catholic Church just reflexively, are now yeah, now they're like, you know, now they're tweeting his, you know, remarks and, you know, like trying to act like, ooh, yeah, pay attention.
He says capitalism stinks. The Pope rocks.
And he cares about global warming, right? It's like the left sure. is like the Pope is now like a scientific authority to the left now.
Yeah.
That's how far we've come in a short time, right?
He did say one interesting thing about how religious people, he said Christians shouldn't, first of all, they shouldn't own guns. That was one that was really bizarre to me. Like, you can't be a Christian if you own a gun. Thought that was strange. And he also said
a real slap in the face to all of his staff.
Yeah, seriously.
Gosh, right. Boss, I thought we were all going to heaven. Nope.
Yeah, not you guys. Thanks for taking the hit.
Yeah.
Taking a bullet for the team, so to speak.
Oh,
so,
man.
The other thing he said was that, like, he was standing up for that woman who wouldn't give gay marriage licenses. He was basically saying that Christians don't have to obey the law about that. And that's one thing I give him credit for. Like, hey, you know, following your conscience is always awesome.
Yeah, and if you have a government job, not doing it is always awesome. So,
right. Yeah, so I was happy. Oh, Kim Davis, that's her name.
Right.
Yeah.
I mean, sure, she's a horrible, nasty, bigoted, you know, mean person. But why she doesn't want to do her job, right? Who should argue with that?
Hey, I don't know, but a bunch of the gays, even the anarchist gays, were giving me a hard time for supporting Kim Davis because I was like, hey, this is great. You know, I want more people like her who say, I don't care what the law says. I'm going to follow the law that's written on my heart. Now, I disagree with her about, you know, gays and equality and everything. I myself am gay. I would hope to have the same rights as everybody else. But for her to say, this violates my conscience and I won't do it, takes courage. And I would like to see more courage in the world like hers.
Well,
so,
you know,
even though she's
I don't know
wrong
if courage
about
is
the issue,
right word that I would use. But, let's just imagine that every county
jail
clerk.
Time.
Well, let's just imagine every county clerk in the country did exactly what she did and just stopped filing their papers. Right?
Yeah.
Wouldn't that solve the whole gay marriage, straight marriage controversy once and for all? Suddenly, there'd be no more marriage licenses.
Well, if she did it for that reason, if she said, like, well, the government shouldn't be involved in marriages at all, and I'm not going to be a part of it, then Liberty people would be cheering her on.
Right. Instead, she got the job to pass out the forms and then refused to do it.
You're listening to Freedom Fiends with Michael Dean and his weird friends, tasing you with liberty since 2011. Learn more at freedomfiends.com.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help keep the Freedom Fiends around well into the future. Simply go to freedomfiends.com and click on the Torrent Club link and learn how to torrent and share Freedom Fiends archives.
Freedom Fiends! More freedom than the Fed can handle. So, Jim, I want to tell you a little bit about San Francisco.
Furries or fiend phone unnecessary random re-education interruption exigency system, also known as furries.
Furries.
My cats are raping each other.
No. And, you know,
I'm not like calling in like, hey, pet line, tell me what to do if my cats are raping each other. I'm calling to brag because it's I love having wild beasts in my home. That if I...
And your cats.
If I died, they'd eat me. They'd eat my wife. It's our 9th wedding anniversary. They'd still...
Hey!
Congratulations.
Happy anniversary.
Yeah, I care. It's cool. I don't care that the cats would eat us, though. That's what cats do. Dogs are polite. They're all domesticated. They're all on leashes
and stuff.
They'll eat you, too.
They'll still eat you.
Not really. Oh, no, yeah. that guy that... They found dead, supposedly a murder-suicide, that guy I interviewed that was making that movie.
Yeah. The dog was still alive.
And dog was still alive and was not eating them. Yeah, like two, like 3 weeks later, the dog was starving and freaking out.
He was eating the cats that were eating
him. Probably would eat the cats, yeah.
Let the cats fill up on the people, then eat the cat.
Yeah. Cats will eat you after like a day, man. They don't care.
Yeah.
They're really raping each other. They're both girls. They're both fixed. They're young. They're like 3 months old, and they're just jumping on each other and like biting the nape of their neck and like mounting each other. And it's cool, man. They're taking turns. If they're hunting, they're basically hunting.
About how old are they now?
3 months.
Okay.
Here, say hi, kitties. They were like.
Do you let them outside? Do they play with other kitties, or are they?
Hell no. No.
Okay. Hey, they're not free yet.
That would be catarchy.
The cat Charlie that we had, who was 17, was an indoor outdoor cat. But she didn't roam the neighborhood. Like we have a fenced in backyard, and I'd let her out there like when I could look out the window and keep an eye on her. But she was found like outside, you know, like you couldn't keep her in. She would howl all night. But no, we decided we're never going to let any other cats out. They have lowered life expectancies. They get eaten by other beasts.
Cats live a long time anyway.
Fleas and other parasites they can bring back into the house.
Forget about it. Yeah, that's reason enough.
Currently, only children. No pets.
Skin pets. You call them skin pets.
Hmm.
Yeah.
You never heard that?
No.
I've never heard that. Is that a thing?
It's really that sounds disgusting. I like it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I call them cats fur children.
You could peel off their skin.
Fur children are the cats.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So when I went to my my vet today, my lung human lung vet for my checkup, I told him how much like better I was now that he's dealing with my GERD or, you know, antacid problems, which really like was getting acid in my lungs. My lungs were tripping and it wasn't good. But he was like, and what else is new? And I'm like, well, you're not gonna like this, but I got cats. Cause like I'm allergic to cats, and cats are like the worst allergens, you know, because they like, they're not only you're allergic to them, like they run around on the floor and get dust and then like climb on your face while you're sleeping, you know.
Did your doctor dump you?
Almost, man. He said, why would you do that? Literally, like most people you say, hey, I got cats. They're like, cool. But like the scientist who knows the science of it and my unique condition, I'm like, hey, I got cats. And he's like, why would you do that? That was the exact wording and inflection. And I was like, I don't know, man. It'd be like asking a parent, you know, why did you take your kids back out of the orphanage instead of leaving them there? And he's like, okay. Like, and he wrote something down. Like,
he like scribbled.
Uncooperative.
This guy's crazy.
Yeah. Dump as soon as.
Refer to the psychiatrist. Yeah.
Dump as soon as the new Obamacare year starts. In a few months. Yeah. Man, these cats.
Well, do the cats like bite at you? A lot of kittens. Yes. Yes. I don't know how to teach them not to bite me. I don't like that. Well, do they grow out of it?
You should have dogs.
I don't.
My cat never grew out of that. In fact, it would try to kill my friends. Like, literally. Yeah. Like, it would it would go into this, like life and death mode. And and would literally, I'd have to mop up puddles of blood. It was, like, that bad for this cat. Yeah.
Why do people do this? Why do they suffer through that? I mean, how much fun can they be?
They're a lot of fun. Let's chase each other.
Yeah, okay.
They don't make you bleed.
Mopping up blood
is just bleed.
Yeah, that's great. Then the friends love it too.
Oh yeah. Well, it keeps people from visiting too much. You know, that's one bonus.
Yeah,
that cat's name was Flesh Ripper, and I do miss
Flesh Ripper. In German, it's Flesh Ripper.
I'm glad you got cats, Michael. You know, some friends and fellow co-hosts on LRN the Liberty Radio Network, they just got a dog, and they keep it on a leash, and it's so sad to me ever since the campaign for leashes came around. It's the Rebel Love Show guys.
Yeah.
They got a dog.
Right?
It's sad.
All of a sudden that, like, he's on every post on Twitter I'm on. I like him, but I almost want to be like, hey, dude, kind of like ease into my panties, you know? Like, don't just jump in.
Are you sure that's him and not the parody account?
I don't know. I can't even tell. I'm like talking with like 8 parody accounts.
There's a parody account of the Rebel Love Show guys.
It's probably them then.
So it's probably that. Yeah.
Yeah.
But he did just get a dog, and I'm seeing all these pictures with the leash on and the collar and everything, and it's so sad. I've never thought about it until, like, now the campaign for longer leashes, and you have cats, and they have freedom. Except I'm sad to hear they don't go outside. I mean, they don't really have freedom.
Do they see the
birds, and they're scratching at the window?
Yeah. And then they're like, oh, Rebel Luck Show, that's who's bothering me. I mean, you know,
is that him? It's Rebel Love Show is the actual Rebel Luck Show. Rebel
Luck Show.
That's got to be the parody.
But it's at Rebel Love Show is the Twitter name. So I think it's really him. I think he's doing all of them. Or is it, who does the parody?
Shire Dude?
Theories. Yeah, that's Rebel Love Show, right? Shire Dude?
Yeah. But he's, Shire Dude and Rob Rebel.
Katie, say hi.
And his rebel mistress.
God, they're just running around with
Does he do parodies noise. Of himself? Is that?
I don't know. I don't know who any of the parody accounts are.
I heard it's all Nick Ryder.
I mean, he must listen to a lot of LRN, because there's no way.
Oh, they live tweets it. I mean, like you know, he's probably tweeting. One of these accounts is probably commenting on what we're saying right now.
Nice.
Yeah. But it's amazing.
Whoever it is listens to every Free Talk Live and every Freedom Fiends. I'm sure of that.
They're good.
Wow.
I think there are multiple people. It's got to be. They can't just be one person. There are so many accounts now.
There's King Mark Googling.
Hilarious.
There's Ian Freeman Googling. There's the really mean one.
My favorite is King Mark.
There's the really mean one that's Cantwell doing me and wishing I'm dead. It's called Michael Dean Googling, which is MWD Googling. And that's the one that I got it to stop tweeting by tweeting at it something about, I want to see Cantwell's unsealed, what was it you were on last night?
His
criminal record with cat strangling and arson. And all of a sudden he just like stopped tweeting at me like. It was too close to whatever, you know, to something.
That was too close to home. Don't even get started with Bear Mace.
Yeah. I just followed this MW Dean, Michael Dean Google, and the last post was like September 9th.
Yeah, that's when I posted the thing about cat strangling and arson. Like
Michael put him to bed.
I put him to bed. There's another one though that likes me. That's a parody account of me. It's well, if you go to
Michael Musing.
Michael Musing, yeah.
Yeah, I love that one.
We were going to give these out last night. We forgot to. So, let's see. King Mark Googling. Cantwell Googling is hilarious. You seen that one? It's
Cantwell Goo. Googling is hilarious.
Cantwell Goo is the name of that one. Yeah, that one. The picture up on Cantwell Goo right now is like her Hieronymus Bosch picture of like me and Lou tree panning Cantwell, like drilling a hole in his skull.
I say King Mark is definitely the best one. I mean, there's no question.
Googling is pretty funny.
Ian Googling, you have to know Ian a little bit. Yeah, you have to know his character. With King Mark, it's just funny jokes for anyone. Anyone could tune into that.
There's a Jim Jesus Googling too, but it's not very active. And the Michael,
the picture
using hasn't been active in about a month. But it was really accurate.
The Michael Musen picture is you with a microphone to your nose, right?
yes. And the Michael Dean Googling one is me like holding my old cat, Charlie, who like weighs like 40 pounds. Like I can barely hold her up to the microphone. She looks dead, but she's alive.
Who's that comedian that Jim Jesus looks like?
His picture is it's my favorite comedian. See, Louis C.K.
Yeah. Yeah, that's his picture for Jim Jesus Googling.
Yeah.
Just so people can find it. Yeah. Any more parody accounts?
I don't know. Maybe we should just shut up and talk about space. What do you think, Jim?
about space, like Mars?
I
like the water they found on Mars?
I listened to yesterday's show today when I got up. And I laughed for like 2 hours straight. You guys were great.
Oh, yeah. It was hilarious. Yesterday's episode. Yeah. I was telling Jim before the show, I was so jealous listening on the radio at KGay 88.1 in San Francisco that I wanted to jump in and be a part of your party. I mean, like, not jump in on the radio, but in person.
You could jump in in person, I see.
Yeah, I wanted to hang out with you guys. It seemed like you guys were having fun. It was so hilarious.
What's this picture of Catwell with a Muppet cop? What's the story behind that? That's pretty funny. He looks like the Muppet cop.
I think he has
some Muppets
paper bag puppet. Yeah, like
no, it's like a real Muppet, like homemade a nice you know store made one.
Oh, he's probably got some puppets of a cop. I think he's got that. Why not? Why wouldn't he? What else does he do at home?
I don't know.
He's got to entertain the people locked in his basement somehow.
Oh man. Now see, Derrick knows the guy. He can make these jokes. I've never met him.
Yeah, he doesn't have anyone locked in his basement. He's alone. Okay.
He's a lonely man. He's a lonely man.
That would imply like some kind of human interaction that is not happening. Yeah.
I heard he had a girlfriend for about a week, but then she dumped him, didn't she?
Yeah. I don't know if she dumped him. He's pretty successful with the ladies. I got to be honest. There are apparently
ladies
women out
a-holes.
There with very low
ladies
standards.
Love a-holes. You know, no, I mean, like, he's not that bad of a looking guy. He's charismatic. Yeah. He's funny. He's smart. But there's still reasons that women would dump him, I'm sure. All right, we're out.
Poor gun etiquette.
Poor gun. Yeah. Ladies do not mate with men with poor gun etiquette.
You're listening to Freedom Fiends. Go to freedomfiends.com to help keep it drone-proof.
When you shop online, please do it through the Freedom Fiends Amazon link over on the right side of freedomfiends.com. It won't cost you any extra, and the fiends will get a little taste from Amazon, and Amazon will save you the danger of drive-by stabbings at your local mall. Amazon sells pretty much everything you can buy on this earth, except for guns and weed. But they do sell the DVD Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. So get that for your gun-hating stoner brother or neocon gun nut dad. They'll thank you for it. That's freedomfiends.com. Freedom, Foxtrot, Echo, Echo, November, Sierra.com.
Philadelphia, with Derrick J. In San Francisco.
In Feens Cisco. San Feens Cisco.
San Feens Cisco. Yeah. I like that.
It's been great. I moved from Feen, New Hampshire, just to be here with my man. And it's really great. Things are going really well. It's so different from Feen. The main difference is that people are young and healthy.
Where? In California?
In California, okay. Yeah. There's a lot of walking around required, and it's hilly, so everyone has a nice butt and nice legs, and they eat
it
really healthy.
It is quite the vertical city. I mean, you really get some nice calf muscles just walking around. Just
You've
normal,
got to.
Just walking like from one block to another, you know, could be like it's like mountain climbing.
Yeah, seriously. And like no one is fat. If you see anyone who's fat, they're a tourist. They're just visiting. They're from somewhere else. That's been pretty nice. So like lots of young, attractive people. There are clubs to go to, lots of restaurants. You know, there aren't as many anarchists. I'll say that. I really miss that about New Hampshire is like every day, pretty much everyone that I encountered was a straight up voluntarist, anarchist, you know, philosophically. They wanted freedom and they wanted to leave me alone and I wanted to be left alone. So it worked out perfect.
Well, how long have you been there?
I've been here about a month.
Okay. I think it's a little soon. Right, to judge the number of anarchists. Give it another month, 2 months, right, and you will have converted like a much larger segment. But within 6 months, there's going to be more anarchists in San Francisco than anywhere else in the world.
You know, that could be true because there is a seditious radio station that's broadcasting here in San Francisco, KGay 88.1. People can listen to that, and they're just going to be. Their minds are going to be blown at some of the things that they hear, you know, from the shows that cover the news and have no shame about talking about how they see no need for government. And that government's usually the problem. Because most of the things that I hear on radio or on or in the world, just conversing with most of these people, is like, oh, well, you know, the government screwed up. So the solution is we need a little more government.
Exactly.
We just always didn't have enough last
time.
Isn't
that always the way it is? Yeah.
It's amazing that that's always their solution.
But suddenly, if you can just slip in this little idea that says, hey, the government screwed up right there, maybe we should just not have those guys be in charge of that. What do you think? You know? And maybe they just need a chance to be like, oh, I didn't know that was an option. Oh.
Yeah.
Well, now that you mention it, yeah. Because the government in California is one of the most ridiculous, right? Aren't they they tell people how long of a shower they can take and there's all kinds of
The sides of buses. I'm seeing that on the sides of buses. It's so bizarre. I mean, they're so authoritarian. It's weird. I don't know if they have these ads that play in Philadelphia, Jim, but when I'm on the bus in San Francisco, I'm hearing this ad that goes over like every 5 minutes or so. It's like, when you're riding the bus, put your phone down and like look around. Like, don't look down at your phone. Like, look around you. And I'm like, why would I do? I don't know. I think they're saying like, be cautious, be aware.
Because the transit cops might want to shoot you. That's why.
Yeah, maybe.
Just to avoid another random BART execution, right?
Yeah, unfortunately, yeah. That stuff doesn't really happen in San Francisco proper, I've noticed. It's just when you go outside, like into the areas like Oakland and some of the bad neighborhoods. But San Francisco itself, I haven't seen any issues with the cops here. People, they just generally are friendly and are helping people. The only time that they really bother anyone is the homeless people who, you know, they lounge around on the streets and stuff. But the worst the cops do is go through with their sirens, like, woo, woo. You know, and just scare everyone as they're passing through the streets.
I hate that too, though. I don't like that.
I don't like that either. But if that's the worst of their problems, you know, that's not so bad.
They can.
I will say this:
they show some restraint. They don't just like just shoot them to make a point.
Well, yeah, they've got a little bit more restraint. They are terrified of guns around here. We 3D printed a. Which basically, it's like a miniature gun. You know, you could print it any size you want, but we printed one real small. It's like a squirt gun. And showed it to some of the housemates around here, and they freaked out. You can't have that.
No. Did they call 911? I hope not.
You have to register that. No, they didn't call 911. We told them it was a squirt gun, and they got relieved. Oh, okay. Phew. Just shoots water. All right.
They can handle it.
Yeah, that's safe.
Wait till they see your gun collection.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's antiwar.com.
Trigger warning. This is the Freedom Fiends. Broadcasting through the Libertarian Reeducation Center's low orbit ion cannon, high atop Financial Beast Plaza, on the artificial satellite LibPair 2017 in the Alpha Centauri region. The Freedom Fiends is covered by a BIPCOT no government license. This allows reuse by anyone except governments. Learn more at BIPCOT.org. All right. Here with Derrick J. and Michael W. Dean. Are you still with us?
I am.
All right. I guess we lost Michael. I think the cats are
he's
getting a little too rowdy.
One of his
they're too frisky. Anyway.
They take after their papa.
So, you know, we were talking about California, and, you know, it seems like such a wonderful place to me. I love visiting California. I love particularly San Francisco as a city. One of my favorite cities in the world, at least as a tourist when I visited there. But, you know, yeah, the government is weird over there. Like, they're really
authoritarian central planning. Is it just a coincidence that they have this drought? Okay, it's like, it seems like whenever you have like a real drought authoritarian government, there's always a lot of droughts, aren't there? And famines.
It's a lie. The drought is a lie. I'm not convinced that there is one. You know, they talk about, oh, there's not a lot of rain or whatever. But I mean, I'd like to see, maybe there is some evidence about it, but it just seems like a way to control people. Like, they just always bring up, oh, yeah, you know, there's a drought, so we can't use this water or whatever. Like, I heard this professor... Yeah. We were walking by a beautiful fountain, or what should have been a beautiful fountain, but there was no water running. And he was like pointing, there was some tourist, and he was pointing like, oh yeah, this, when it's all lit up, it looks beautiful. And he's like, well, what is it? And he's like, oh, you know, there's water shooting out of it. And well, they turned it off a couple of years ago. You know, the water recycles, but it just kind of looked bad, you know, that we're in a drought and everything. So it's like, it's not even something that wastes water. It completely recycles the water. But they didn't want to look bad because, you know, there's a drought. So we're telling other people not to water their lawns. So what are we doing with our fountain? It's like, why make the world a worse place?
Well, probably because all the homeless people were bathing in it, too. That might be something.
But that's the other thing that's really bizarre about this place, Jim. Like, I've never been to a place quite like San Francisco, and especially in this time. Like, it almost seems to be like an elite city. Like, you really have to be a bajillionaire to live here, and I'm finding that out pretty quick. Like, I don't know if I fit in here. Yes, sir. Okay, well, yeah, it's probably because I rebooted, so I'll fix that. Thanks. I'll do what I can. Well... Tell me about your experiences in San Francisco, Jim.
Well, it's really just as a tourist, and I just really enjoyed the food, particularly whether it was from like these sort of like working man's like burrito joints to some of the more high-end restaurants. I just thought it was all fantastic. International cuisine, Pacific Rim vibe, just gorgeous scenery. You know, I didn't really have to deal with any of the authority figures or the, any of those central scrutinizers that are on the rampage over there.
Well, fortunately, I really haven't either had to deal with these central scrutinizers. They pretty much leave you alone in a big city. Like, I was experiencing local government all the time in Feen, New Hampshire, but not here in San Francisco.
Well, remember, Feen, New Hampshire, you were like the excuse for them to get a bear cat, right? Like,
yeah, seriously.
We've got this guy on a bicycle, and he has no regard for authority whatsoever. We're gonna need two bear cats. Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. You know, speaking of, I got the sad news that the state Supreme Court of New Hampshire decided to uphold the decision to deny me a concealed carry license. So you don't need the state's permission to openly carry a gun in Vermont or Maine, the neighbors of New Hampshire, the live free or die state. But in New Hampshire, see, you need the government's permission to put that gun in your car or in your pocket or under a coat. You need to ask permission for that and pay money to the state. And they have this one sneaky little word in there that says, you know, it's a shall issue state. And if you're not a felon or a domestic violence person and you haven't been in a mental hospital, then you shall be issued a license. That's what it sounds like. But then they snuck this word in there. None. I qualify. They just snuck one word in that says, oh, and also if the chief of police doesn't deem you suitable. You know, suitable, like whatever that means. They don't even define it in the law anywhere. So it's totally open to interpretation. And I look great in a suit, by the way. So I think I'm more suitable than anyone else in New Hampshire. But they, and I've been totally peaceful.
It took me a second.
Yeah. I've been totally peaceful. Even when the cops come and attack me, they pepper spray me. They knock me to the down to the ground. They've chased me for no reason.
Right. And for anybody that's seen your documentary, Derrick J's Victimless Crime Spree, you really make it almost seem fun. Like as they're chasing you, like, and one, like, wow, okay, my friend's about to get kidnapped.
but yet I'm still like laughing at it. So that's, you really brought a unique sort of a unique like funness to your kidnappings and assaults. So I really compliment you on that. Yeah.
Well, it was fun, but I hope it's worth me not being able to get this concealed carry license, because that is essentially the reason that the chief of police denied me. He said that I didn't have respect for police. like that's some sort of requirement. I'm like, yeah, I don't. Yeah, you don't respect us, so we're not going to give you this license. It's like, I don't think that's part of the qualification, sir.
And, you know, there's a reasonable chance that you might have like put change in someone else's parking meter at some time. I don't know if you're one of those guys, but you're at least friends with people that have like just, you know, put change in parking meters, you know, with no regard, with complete disregard for this, for the city's ability to generate revenue on parking violations.
You know, I did try and shake the hand of the chief of police before when he took out the smart meters that they have in most places, you know, where in Keene they still have the coin-fed meters where you actually can feed someone else's parking meter. But in most cities, like in Philadelphia, they've got those smart meters where it prints out a ticket, you have to put it on your dash, and that way you can't transfer your payment to the next person once you leave.
Right.
You also can't pay for your neighbor. Well, they tried that in Keene, and it was so unpopular among the businesses and the townspeople that the chief of police actually did the right thing and took them out.
Wow.
And that couldn't have been easy. So I tried to shake his hand and thank him. His name is Ken Miola. I said, Ken, thank you. I thought you made the right decision. He would not even look me in the eye. He walked past me.
He was ashamed.
I hope so. Maybe. Yeah. Maybe that's. I don't know.
He just couldn't bear to face you because he knows that that you have no respect for him.
That's true. I mean, but I did respect him in that one instance. I thought he did the right thing. He should be commended for it. But anyway, I'm complaining about not having enough freedom in New Hampshire. Meanwhile, in California, I mean, getting a gun.
Nobody gets a gun, right?
Yeah, it takes.
Nobody is deemed suitable.
I have been shooting here, though. I've been shooting here like more frequently than I did in New Hampshire, honestly. There's a shooting range in South San Francisco that's pretty popular. I mean, it's always packed, and the Pink Pistols go there, a little gay group of shooters. So, you know, it's got a gun scene. It's got a gun culture. I even see some people with like NRA bags and hats and stuff. Not that I'm a fan, but... it's cool to see that there are other people.
Are they like pink or rainbow colors for the NRA bags? Or
yeah, they are. Nice. You know, hey, whatever floats your goat.
Yeah.
So, you know, I have been shooting here a few times, and that's been fun. But the culture is very different. There were no clubs to go to in New Hampshire, like really none, and they were all like over 50. It was like a geriatric home. So, you know, coming here, it's like a new planet. I can't believe it's even considered the same country.
It might, to some, it's not really. It's not.
Right. It's not. What's a country?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I can't wait to see it after you've had an influence on them for a little while. I think there's going to be some very interesting developments. I can't wait to see how this plays out.
Well, I'll tell you one of them, and you're a friend of the courthouses in your area. You know, I've been thinking one of the things that could affect New California and San Francisco really well is to go to some of the courthouses in Oakland where the police are really bad and arresting people for no reason and hand out those don't take the plea deal flyers like we do in Keene.
Yeah.
I mean, in Keene, there's someone handing out a don't take the plea deal flyer every morning that someone has an arraignment.
But once a week? It's not very often, right?
No, it's half the month. It's the first 2 weeks of every month. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah, it is pretty often. And I'd like to see that same thing happen here in San Francisco. We've started what I like to call the gaynarchists, which is a group of gay anarchists. And, you know, I don't know. There's no reason really to segregate ourselves apart from the non-queer population other than just like, I don't know, hey, it's fun. We have this one thing in common. And I would like to see the gaynarchists step up and do some outreach, do something that's going to make an impact in San Francisco, not just a butt waxing party, which is also great.
I would have no way of knowing that, but I can only imagine that is great. Yeah. So,
Yeah, why not take a leadership role out there? I think there's obviously a lot of people that need you out there. So, and the gay anarchist group sounds like a great way to sort of maybe create a team of sort of ambassadors that can interface with, you know, with the greater area. So
It is really cool. Like the other day, I was with some of the gay anarchists, and there was one There was one statist among us. So it was four gay guys, three of us anarchists, and one statist. And it was so cool to see what it sort of felt like for the statist to be the odd one out. You know, like every time he was bringing up like, oh, yeah, you know, of course there should be licensing for this and that. It's like, well, you know, has that ever helped? Is it actually... you know, producing the result that you want. I mean, and where does anyone even get the authority to decide that you need a license for this? You know, why shouldn't someone be able to sell pharmaceuticals if they want to? You know, why shouldn't the customer be able to decide what's right for him? And, you know, it was very interesting to see someone sort of on the defense for statism.
Right.
You know, that is really cool. And it was just something that I never really saw in New Hampshire, because everyone's an anarchist there.
Right. So your group could handle, you know, could work with the statists and the straightists, right? Like,
yeah, we convert all.
Yeah. No, you know, that's the group I'd want to hang out with. I mean, you know, as a straightist, could I hang out with you guys?
Yeah, sure. But you have to have the butt waxing initiation.
Ooh.
You're listening to Freedom Fiends. So much truth, it hurts.
Are you sick of government lackeys who say, you didn't build that? Are you tired of elitists like Barack Obama and Al Gore taking credit for the web while trying to take over the web? Are you disgusted by experts whose concept of the internet is that it's a series of tubes? Take back the free market of computing by encouraging software developers to adopt the BIPCOT-NOGOV license. The BIPCOT-NOGOV license allows any use or modification except by governments. Go to BIPCOT.org. That's Bravo, India, Papa, Charlie, Oscar, Tango.org.
Welcome back to the Freedom Fiends. More catarchy than you can handle. So I was just telling Jim. Was that Jim?
Yeah, I was going to say, tell us, you were saying about this ice cream thief
I didn't want to bring it up. But yeah, in the cult house, there is a thief among us. And this is something, I think I brought it up the other day, that I had just gotten an email, and I like got it live on air, like one of the head honchos, like one of the beloved children of Jim Jones, I mean, Mama Satoy, wanted to let everybody know. She titled the email like, "Not the ice cream, guys," with a little sad face. And I was, oh no, someone ate her ice cream from the freezer.
It's not like somebody like stole her weed or, you know, her booze. Yeah. Like they went for the ice cream.
It was nothing important. Yeah.
That is the lowest of the low. Because what it's saying is your integrity is worth less than a Nutty Buddy. You know, like, I mean, it's terrible.
Well, we're not allowed to have weed or anything in the house. There's a no drug policy at Mama Satoy's compound.
Oh, you talk about the cult again? I'll listen. I love every night.
Yeah, we got an update on that.
I almost don't care how much you suffer, because it makes for such great radio.
It's so bad, Michael. I hate it. I want to get out of there so bad. Yeah, but one of the... I read this email on the air, and then as I left, another email came in, and another two more in the morning before... So the second one was like, yeah, I wasn't going to say anything, but I had ice cream in the freezer too, and my ice cream disappeared. So someone's been eating entire tubs of ice cream. They're like,
I think do a sting operation.
Camera.
I think I should set up a video camera somewhere.
Put some ice cream in and put laxative in it. That's what I did.
I was going to say rat poison, but yeah, laxative would be a little nicer.
Laxative is, yeah.
Rat poison would solve it, you know, once and for all, though.
No, that's not nice. Yeah, and you're like, you were mad at me for like joking that Cantwell should eat his gun, and you're sounding kind of serious with the rat poison.
No, of course I'm joking. I would never.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He meant Flintstones too.
I would never ruin perfectly good ice cream that way. That would
no, be. You put in laxative and flies, man. That's what we did. We had a roommate.
Ew, why flies? Just to be gross?
Yeah, just so you can go, oh, we made you eat flies. So when you're sitting on the toilet for 12 hours, we took chocolate X-lax, like 12 doses of it. Whatever, you know, when you buy it, you buy a bunch of it. And we chopped it up and mixed it in a chocolate brownie mix, put it on the table, put a sign, Tom, do not eat this. and we got flies from, like, we, you know, went up in the light in the middle of the kitchen, unscrewed the big bulb.
Oh, gross. Yeah, poured, all the like, dead
years
flies.
Of dead flies and a couple worms. Yeah.
And you're saying that rat poison is worse than that? Yeah. I don't
That's
know.
That's going too
he
far.
He lived, man. He lived. He lived and went on to be actually a prominent college basketball player, but I'm not going to say who he is.
Well, apparently this ice cream thief didn't just stop at ice cream. He's eaten entire family-sized bags of chips.
He ate an entire family.
He ate a poor child. So four of these emails came in within the span of a couple of hours. And so then Mama Satoy angrily types, you know, with her all caps email, "This is the end of this thread." And just put an end to it. Like, we're not going to talk about this anymore. I hope that it comes up the next, like, Sunday meeting. Because we're going to be talking about...
No, thread's over, man.
Right, no, and it's going to say, no, it's going to be in all caps, and don't talk about this on your radio shows.
Well, the next Sunday meeting that we're going to, I have to help present the topic, and it's about privilege. And I really can't wait to, talk to all of these immigrants and...
these immigrants.
You know, other people, all these people who are going to tell me that I have a bunch of privilege and I should feel ashamed. It's
I
like,
would check their homo sapien privilege. That's the obvious thing.
Yeah, well, I
mean,
I'm
they have opposable
have to,
thumbs, man. Jeez.
I hate the idea that just because of my skin color, I'm being judged this way.
You know,
like,
how hard it is for the cats to rape each other without opposable thumbs? They have to use their teeth, man. That
they got
hurt.
Claws. they have claws. They can hold on.
Hey, I got good news. Let me interrupt you for a sec. A bunch of FCC field offices are closing down.
Yay!
Which means they'll be less. It'll be less likely and harder for them to go out and poke people. The ones, the following offices will close. Oh, James is gonna like this: Philadelphia, Buffalo,
all right,
Detroit, all right, Houston, Norfolk, San Diego, Seattle, Tampa. Offices to remain open will be Hawaii, Anchorage, Alaska, Portland, New York City, Portland, Oregon, Columbia, Maryland, Chicago, Illinois, Atlanta, Miami, Los Angeles, San Francisco, Denver, aww, Boston, New Orleans, Kansas City, field office.
Wait a minute. Who even knew they had that many offices? And what do they do in these offices?
Sell natural resources.
You're listening to the Freedom Fiends, and I'm beaming these words into your cerebellum.
My fellow sheep, election season is upon us. Are you one of the 12% of Americans who still approves of our government? Then we need your help to force the other 88% into compliance. Our democracy depends on it. We're an organization called Citizens Against Too Much Unfettered Freedom, or CATMUF. CATMUF is a bipartisan flock of sheep whose goal is expanding government until nothing else remains. Because the government is here to help you. How can you help CATMUF help you? By only voting for candidates dedicated to expanding government. It's easy. You don't need to study the issues. No matter what a politician says when running for office, they're all dedicated to expanding government. And make sure you tell all your friends and family to vote for more government. Here at CATMUF, we don't care if you vote Democrat or Republican, as long as you vote for candidates committed to growing our federal family. CATMUF, because folks just aren't smart enough to handle real freedom.
Welcome back to the Freedom Fiends. Relax your statism away.
You know, speaking with the freedom of relaxing... Isn't that weird? I was giving myself a wedgie at yoga the other day, Jim. There's
on
a
purpose? Or
yeah, there's
was
something.
That
a, no, no, it's accidental. No, It's a real thing. It's just
I don't know all the gay lingo, Derrick. So
no, it's just a product of wearing short shorts and doing yoga.
Okay.
there's no double entendre here. It's very literal. Okay. But it's a really cool thing called Yoga to the People. And what's so cool about it is it's a donation-based yoga studio at the top of this San Francisco building. You have to climb all the way to the top of it, and the whole top floor is this big dojo. And, I mean, I don't know what they call it in yoga, but it's a big wooden floor. And, you know, they can rent you mats, they sell water, but everything is by donation. So they have, like, suggested donation, but they'll give you a mat, and they'll give you water, and they'll just give you the lesson, and you can walk out. But a lot of these people, I mean, it's the mission, which I guess is known for being mostly Hispanic in the past, but these days
it's populating itself. It was the drunken Irish, and then it was the Mexicans, and then it was the hipsters.
Well, now it's the really rich Chinese people. They never got they had Chinatown.
They locked and there's in Japantown. Chinatown. They're still there.
Yeah. And it still is there. It's a crazy place. But the cool thing about Yoga to the People is that there's people who have no money, and there's people who have millions of dollars. It's like, it's really bizarre to be in this environment where it is just to pay what you want sort of thing, and they've been keeping it running presumably for years, and the teachers make money, the place keeps their lights open, and it's just a great experience.
You only have to befriend one of those people to be like the most valuable contribution to liberty financially. Like, you have to find like the .com guy who feels that like to alleviate his white guilt, you know, he doesn't have to give his money to like UNICEF. He has to give it to like Free Talk Live and the Freedom Fiends.
Well, find I'll look guy. For that person. Cause like seriously, who's the guy from Facebook?
No, not him.
Not him. Yeah. Not him. Well, he's confused and he's giving all his money away to bad causes. I think he really wants to do good. He's like, I came into way too much money and I need to give some of this away to good causes. But then he's like, here, government, you'll know how to spend this money well. I'm like, yeah. No.
Mm.
Did you guys see the thing today? Free Talk Live mentioned this, but it's so absurd. It just has to be mentioned once everywhere. There's a group of scientists who've signed, like 30 scientists who've signed this letter to President Obama telling him that he should be using the RICO Act against people who deny that global warming is human caused.
What's the RICO Act?
It's like what they use. Didn't they use it on Ross Ulbricht?
Where you put you in a jail cell for the rest of your life as some kind of kingpin.
Conspiracy. Yeah. It's a little different than the kingpin charge, I think, but it's connected with that and used with that a lot. It's conspiracy. It's what they use to bring down the mob.
Right. When they can't actually get them on a real crime. They're like, but we think that you guys all work together crimes happened and you were nearby and you both had the same. Yeah.
Yeah,
you have similar membership cards to the same gym. And
there are men and women of science, you know, people who say that they put empirical thought and scientific process above everything else. We're basically saying the science we're presenting isn't convincing people. Let's start lopping off heads. They're basically going to the dark ages with science.
Wow. You know what? Just tell them to talk about space and shut up.
I like that. I made that a hashtag today. I think that should be a hashtag. Jim, did you come up with that or Jim Jesus? I like it a lot.
I think Jim Jesus did.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're making fun of Neil deGrasse Tyson.
So easy.
For just being such an awful spokesman for science. And
what? Why? Why is he bad? Because he loves government or something? Or
yeah, he loves government. And he went out of his way to try to explain to people how private enterprise will never open the doors to space. We'll never have space exploration without the government.
No, man, we'll have ice fishing on the moon brought to you by Red Bull.
Yeah, I saw one weird one. Speaking of men of science or pseudoscience, that Bill Nye has jumped into the political scene lately.
He's horrible.
Yeah, not only about global warming, though.
At least Neil
deGrasse Tyson calls himself the science guy.
No, he just plays one on TV. He's not a scientist. Neil deGrasse Tyson is sort of science. Yeah, if you're going to go for pop science, I really like the Mythbusters guys. They're fun. And they shoot guns sometimes. But whenever they shoot guns or blow anything up, they have like eight people from six government agencies with clipboards. Have you noticed that? I guess they have to in San Francisco, but
you know, every once in a while a cannonball does like leave the studio.
Well, they're on an island in the middle of the bay. I mean, don't you think those guys know enough science that they could just secede and like have their own 4-man army? And well,
do you remember that there was that incident where a cannonball did like go through somebody's house, like something?
Oh, from
like
that show?
Yeah,
yeah, I believe it.
They're like, oops. There's so many things getting blown up and cannons made and
pot
explosives
falling
into
people's houses.
Wow. Yeah. That smell is everywhere. As I walk around the streets, even the nice neighborhoods, it's pot smell everywhere. And it's nice.
But it smells nice?
It's pleasant pot smell. Yeah. All the rich people. I'm talking about rich people houses. So it's not like it's just the scummy neighborhoods or anything.
Well, the rich people have always had pot. They just can open their windows now.
Yeah. not at the cold house. Nope. No pot allowed.
I know.
Even though it's like medical.
I'll bet Mama Satori's like secretly doing speedballs in the back room.
Probably. And she's probably eating everyone's ice cream.
Ice cream thing. You know, when I first moved to the Bay Area, I lived in Berkeley and I got a job at the University Theater. Is that what it's called? Up on University Avenue in Berkeley. It's a movie theater.
Sure.
The day I started working there, a girl who'd worked there for a long time started stealing money from the till. The day I got fired for it, she stopped. And I found out later from one of my coworkers, like, that's something she would do occasionally when she didn't like someone working there.
Whoa.
Maybe that's what Mama, maybe someone's doing that to try to make you look like an ice cream eater.
It couldn't.
What?
Did we lose him?
Yeah, let's talk about it.
I was going to tell Derek there's no way that he could be accused of being the ice cream thief due to his like trim physique. Like, there's no way they're going to be like, yeah, just look at you, Derek. It looks like you ate a whole tub of ice cream and a bag of chips. No. It's not going to happen.
Yeah, I looked like that when I was 25, too. You just wait, Derek. You just wait.
Yeah, I used to be really skinny when I was his age.
Yeah. Yeah, but when we're out rocking the free world and touring the world and elsewhere, yeah.
But I never did butt waxing though, so I feel like I sort of missed out.
I was never hairy enough. I'm still like barely. I barely have any chest hair. Are you hairy?
You know, and I'm sure the audience has always wanted to know. Like,
I wonder, forget there's an audience.
What is the hair level of our hosts?
I know. It's like I listen to Free Talk Live, and I'm like, man. These guys are such consummate professionals. They would never do the stuff that we do. And then sometimes I'm like, I listen the next day to like the stuff we do. And I'm like, man, Free Talk Live are square. They'd never do the stuff they do late at night on this show.
They'd never discuss their body hair or lack thereof.
Butt waxing on conservative rate. Well, they do, but then they like take calls. I don't know. Free. When they take calls, I call them free squawk live, especially when they're like really bad callers with really bad audio that are like screeching ridiculousness. I don't want to talk to those people.
Well, you know, it's only because of the audio quality that you don't like it, right? Or is it because of what they're...
No, it's sometimes someone calls in on Skype and sounds pretty good and they're still free squawk live. But I love free squawk live. Without them, there'd be no Freedom Friends. But... we're so different and we have such a niche. I love it. I love the difference. Viva la difference, you know? Hey, Derrick J's writing me. All right.
He must have been another near drone strike. The EMP has taken out San Francisco. It's possible.
Yep. Yeah, well, he and I are chatting encrypted. You're not in on it because you don't have this program.
Oh,
yet.
Man. I am downloading that app. The
Fiend the phone.
Telegram.
Fiend app. Phone.
Telegram.
I like that they named it after something that's like been obsolete for 75 years. I guess it's not being used. No one's going to confuse it. Derek?
This just in.
Turn your level back up.
Telegram.
Turn your level back up. Telegram.
Telegram.
You know, the first bike messengers were Telegram delivery boys for Western Union.
On bikes?
Yeah, in New York City like 100 years ago. Yeah, because somebody had to like take the telegram to where it was going. You know?
Cool.
Telegram? Is that where like singing there telegrams came from? I heard you
I
can
think you
actually
do singing telegrams, Derek.
Yeah. Happy birthday!
Wax
it's your birthday.
Butt.
Here's your. Yeah. Yeah. Now turn around.
Okay, turn down a little. Bit. You're a little loud now.
Sorry. Just a little. I'll turn it off.
You're so mighty. I'll turn it off.
I wanted to share with you guys. I heard some exciting news that you can deliver money by UPS faster than the banks can deliver it to Europe. So if you're sending money to Europe, you can actually do it faster with UPS than
just
the
like
banks
stuff a bunch
it.
Of cash in a box and yep. and mail it.
Yeah, it'll get there faster.
Or just send Bitcoin.
Isn't that ridiculous? Yeah, well,
can Bitcoin we stuff a bunch of Bitcoin in a box and mail it over?
Yeah, you could. There's
yeah,
actually, there
it's paper wallets.
Google this, avian. What is it? It's basically the idea of delivering internets over pigeons. Avian protocol.
What? That's crazy.
There's a bit of latency, but yeah. It could work.
Yeah, well, okay. There's actually an RFC for it. It's RFC 1149 from the IETF.
What's an RFC?
Request for comment. Basically, it's a network working group. It's an actual engineering internet group that kind of like runs the internet, like since before the web. But on 4th of July, sometimes they'll do funny ones. And they did one 4th of July, 1990. April 1st, April Fool's Day. They did one called A Standard for the Transmission of IP Datagrams Over Avian Carriers. And it discusses basically like sending floppy disks over pigeons. And then somebody did a follow-up to it. Like, it's all in engineering speak, though. That's the joke of it. But there's a follow-up that talked about, like, and this is back when, like, dial-up was the fastest thing. And somebody talked about, like, sending a 747 of floppy disks and how it would be, like, this you know, take 24 hours to get there and unpack, but it would be, like, this blinding amount of throughput.
Blinding.
Oh, even for now, it'd be, like, faster than anything you could do over tubes now. All right, so... talk about Mama's Toy more.
You're listening to The Freedom Fiends, an invigorating alternative to those other shows.
Hey, this is Squisscar Squiggles from Death Clocks. And you are listening to The Freedom Fiends on the, you know, the radios. And I guess it says worms now. So there you go.
Tired of those old Freedom Fiends buttons? Well, the Freedom Fiends have new button designs.
As always, it's only $10 for 10 buttons, and you'll get these nifty designs. Buy sheep, for sheep, on sheep.
State speech is hate speech.
Two designs for Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom.
Three designs for Fiend Phone.
Pipcot No Gov.
A Freedom Fiends Worms button.
And ask me about my worms.
Go to freedomfiends.com and click on the link at the top that says Buttons.
And now they're bigger buttons.
They used to be 1¼ inch. Now they're 1¾ inch. Dan, they're bigger buttons.
What does freedom mean? Tune in to LRN.FM to find out. LRN.FM is the Liberty Radio Network, a collection of live talk radio and podcasts, all coming from a principled pro-liberty perspective. LRN.FM show hosts aren't left, right, or conspiracy kooks. You can tune in 24/7 to LRN.FM via your phone, computer, satellite, and more. Listen free anytime at LRN.FM. That's LRN.FM.
This show survives on donations from fiends like you. We put that money back into our show and Liberty Outreach and donate most our ad space to Liberty organizations that make a difference. We're also a teaching hospital, educating the next generation of Liberty Talkers on the skills needed to keep the radio flame of truth burning into the future. Put your money where your heart is and make a donation of any amount to the Freedom Fiends. Please go to freedomfiends.com and click on the spinning coin on any post.
Back to the Freedom Fiends. It's our final segment. Redemption.
Hey, Derrick, is it true that California is a one-party consent blackmail state?
Yeah. It's a one-party recording consent state, so I've been recording these group meetings that we've been having.
They're going to catch quite you know what beat you to death in their
Does that mean as long as you know you're recording that you're allowed to do it?
Yeah, as
That's
long as you're...
California is.
Yeah, as long as you're part of the conversation at least once, even if you step in and say, then then it's considered legal for you to record that conversation because you're a part of it. Why shouldn't I be? It's my life. It's my house. It's happening in my house. Like, how can I not record in my house?
They're giving you permission to breathe by living there. It's in the lease, right?
That really is part of the stipulation. Jim, I don't know if you knew this, but like in the lease, it says like you do not have access to the bathroom. You do not have access to the kitchen. You don't have access to the Wi-Fi. I am only giving you these things as a favor. So like just be you have to like be good to this guy.
So so at any time your bathroom privileges could be revoked.
Right. And it's weird, like you have to, so it's nice that they have this obsession with cleanliness.
Leave it better than you found it. Leave it better than you found it.
But like it's getting weird to me that I'm squeegeeing off all the little water droplets in the shower when I when I step out. Ew. Like they keep a squeegee there right on the wall, like that I guess everyone uses or something, and I'm like, you know,
a communal squeegee.
Yeah. So one of
are
the
they a bunch of communists or what are they? Is that how communists live? Yeah. They have one squeegee and one shower for like 25 workers, and they all.
There are six bathrooms in this house, though. So, okay. I mean, it's pretty well distributed, I'd say. And the bathrooms, everything is, like, immaculate. Everything is totally clean because everyone has daily chores that they have
to do. How did Mama Satoli own this house? Like, what capitalism did he do to buy that house? That house has got to be worth over $1 million.
He was a professor at Stanford for a while. And now he does consulting to... Well, he says now he does consulting to Fortune 500 companies.
And tells them how to brainwash their employees.
Well, his husband, Papa Ernie, is a ophthalmologist. So, I don't know.
He's like,
I guess he's
an ophthalmologist. Like,
I just spent $1,000 on glasses.
People hire him when they need good news. He's the ophthalmologist.
Yeah, he goes to failed.com companies and just sits in the lobby like cheering everyone up and telling jokes as guys come in and like cart the furniture and the copper wiring out.
What's going to be things, great? It's like I'm afraid to bring up that I'm like anti-authoritarian because first of all, I can't stand all of these controls. This control freak. Like controls what you can access on the internet because he's got the IP on lockdown. You know, he has to add that through the router. So even if you have friends over, they can't access the internet. And so I use a VPN to have a little bit of privacy there because I'm worried about what he's watching.
Yeah, he's probably watching everything you're watching.
Yeah. And he was telling this story about how one of the people in the house went out with a few of the others and they wanted to go to a bar. So this guy went along and he brought his fake ID. Well, Mama Satoi, he said he chopped him. I chopped him up into little pieces.
What?
Because, he says that. I'm off? Sure. Because he didn't like. Yeah, he didn't like that he disobeyed the law. He was like, that's not the way to do it. There are other ways to change the law. You're supposed to, you know, encourage other people, you know, and build up this revolution. You know, so he's like, he's saying, don't disobey the law. You know, it's bad. You should not drink. And the guy was probably like 20 or something. It's not even like he was, you know, with some 13-year-old.
He could get involved and by the time he's 70, he could have changed that law.
Seriously.
Yeah.
It just doesn't work that way. Nope. So I'm a little bit afraid to bring up my anti-authoritarian views. First of all, because Mama Satoi is such an authoritarian. And second, because he seems to have respect for these guys, these men with badges and their rules.
I think you just need to sort of keep your head down and find a better alternative where you can, you know, live a more free lifestyle.
Let's hope they let me leave.
Oh, that's right. Are you allowed to leave?
Yeah, it's a favor.
Check out anytime you want, but you can never leave.
But what if you said, you know what? I don't want your bathroom favors anymore, and you just brought in your own bucket.
I just put it in the hall.
I'm
right
tired of asking for favors. I got my cellular internet bucket. Connection. I got my bucket, and I got my own portable cooler that I'm going to keep my own ice cream in.
You just
screw all of you.
Pooed the bucket in the common area.
What problem?
That's funny.
This is the end of this thread.
Been a good show. This is the end of this show.